Hello and welcome to Rident's World. Tonight I'm going to be playing Nobunaga's Ambition Sphere of Influence, which is an upcoming game by Koei which releases next week. I'm just going to go and show you some of the basic features of the game. I'll do a portion of one of the scenarios. I'm not completely great at the game, so I'll put that out there right now, but I'll show you what I do know from it, and when I've had a little bit of a go on this game so far, so there's not a lot I've kind of got used to yet. For those unaware, the game is a strategy title. It's not like any of the Warriors titles that people are used to from Koei, and it's more along similar lines to the Romance of the Three Kingdoms games, which some of you may or may not have played. And there has been various other Nobunaga's Ambition games in like Iron Triangle, and the game I'm currently playing is the PC version. There is also PlayStation 4 version, and it basically features all the same things as what this does. And as you can see here, there's a little thing here to say you can post bits to Facebook. And so you can connect your Facebook account and you can post pieces to Facebook, which is a kind of cool feature. You don't have to use it, it's just there if you wish to. I haven't actually set mine up because we're currently under embargo and I'm not going to be sharing anything until it lifts. So once everything's done, I will quite freely share anything I can from here. Before I go into starting a new game, I'm just going to have a look through some of these menus here. I'll just go into the settings menu, for those of you who are playing on a PC, you can see some of the settings which you can use to best optimise the game for yourself. So here we go, we have, you can use the window full screen or no frame mode. You can use up to 1080p on the screen size, and there's only minor pieces with regards to the graphics quality, and I'm set it to the max, but I mean there's only three options there. I think it's about the auto read and auto scroll for when there's text in the game. You have the choice between English and Japanese voice, so for those of you who prefer to have the original voices, the option is there and you would have subtitles in English. There's no other languages available at this stage, unless of course you buy the Chinese version or the Japanese version, and then you'll have Japanese or Chinese subtitles. That's it. Here's the next set of options. It's just some basic bits for should you wish to customize your control schemes and stuff for the game. The scheme here will be a little bit different on the PlayStation version. I haven't played the PlayStation version to compare, unfortunately. That's the last bit. So there's the Facebook posting thing, you can put that on. So just come out of here. You have the option to change the background music. You can set it to whatever you wish from the selections that are available. I've just got it set to default, and just leave it at that, but the choice is there should you wish to amend anything. And then we have the gallery. The gallery will feature things which will be unlocked as you progress through the game, things like the movies, the events in the game, and also additional music. I've only got the opening scene here unlocked at the moment, as you can see. I haven't really gone that far into the game. I've literally only just picked it up, so it's quite fresh for me as well. And then we have the events here. So, as you can see, there's quite a few events to collect during the game. There's 364. So, plenty of content to be unlocking and discovering during the game. We have the various music pieces here, and you can just listen to the pieces as you go along. And it's also got the year from where they are, from where they're from. So this would be ones from earlier games and they're shoved in as well, which is pretty cool. People, I know from seeing the social pages, fans always like the music and like to listen to some of the older music that features in the game. So it's quite a nice feature to have that included. So that's pretty much all that's in the settings menu. This is the feats. This will kind of be, I guess, character offices and things that I've collected during the game. So we're just gonna have a look what's in here. Okay, so these are the these are like the achievements. So we have it's kind of similar. I guess these will tie in with the PlayStation trophies. So you have your bronze, silver, gold, and your platinum here. And it's quite a few to collect. So for those of you who are achievement and trophy collectors, then there's going to be plenty of stuff for you to be doing. We can then go into edit created, oh no, officer directories. We're going to go upwards. So putting an officer in the player's clan will allow you to view their information. And we can put the various officers that are in the game. There are a lot more officers than do feature within Samurai Warriors games. This covers a huge span of the Sengoku history. During the war in the States, from the earlier days of Nobunaga, and there's it starts off, if you start with the campaigns in a time order, you would start off with Nobunaga as a young person first, as a young adult, I believe, or a child, and it progresses through to the Nobunaga that we kind of know from his history and from all his pictures, etc. The one that we know from the Samurai Warriors games, etc. So there are just so many. It's kind of, in a way, as you would kind of expect with regards to the idea of the history and the time period, as these are all officers that existed during the period, usually been documented in history, etc. And there may be a few thrown in there as well. Although these are, I have a look, see if I can find Nobunaga. I will be under Nobunaga Oda. There may be some. I actually have this character in my current game, and you can see the period when he was born, when he died, and the other elements which I've built up in the game. He was in my army, and based on this, when you encounter new officers within the game, or when you have them on your, or you bring them into your army, you will unlock them in here, and you will find out more on their history and stuff. We will, you will see the various different stats here, I believe that's leadership. I can't remember what that is. Intelligence and political. And they're all determining factors which will help building an army and trying to recruit people from other factions and stuff. Usually those with better intelligence are good negotiators, and if you send them out, they will persuade other factions to either side with you against a rebel force or against one of your opposing forces, and it'll help you do that a lot, go through that a lot quicker. So if we go back, we can create our own officers. And as you can see, there are 1,016 slots, so there's plenty of space to make your own officers. You can import, export. I believe these are import, export from online. I made my character here, but let me just if I check him, confirm. Okay, so I've exported one character, which means I believe someone else can import them from their game. Which means you can share your characters amongst other players within the community. We can create and change. So if I make a new character, you can edit the face. There's a load of default faces here. These are your standard ones from the actual game. So these are the historic characters that feature within the game. And then you have your default male, female. So there's a few to choose from. And the artwork that goes that's in here is quite nice. I like how the characters are portrayed. I think they're closer to how they are portrayed within the pictures from the history, within the Japanese temples and documents and things. These cap ones I am unsure about, but I'm sure I'll learn about those later on. So that's kind of... Oh, here we go. So we have in here characters as they appear in some of the other games. And if you notice down the bottom, we have them how they appear in the Samurai Warriors games. So you can choose, if you enjoy the look of your characters from the Samurai Warriors games, you can just choose those. So that's that. You can choose the name. You'll choose a first name and a last name, and it doesn't never gets pronounced. It just gets shown in the text. You can enter the birth, so you have male, female. Change the voice. There's a reasonable selection of voices that are available, and you can depend on which age you are taking your character to be. And as you can see, you can have a male character with a female voice, and I believe a female character with a male voice. So there's your selection.
Just leave it to me!
You can just test them as you're going along. You can then select your father, and I believe this will kind of determine your place in history. So, if I was to, for example, pick this guy. Confirm. And then it'll kind of put me in a bit of a history, give me a bit of history. It'll kind of put me into a tier. And gives me a lifespan, etc. So you can, yeah, so you can mess around with that, or you can have it as a relative, and it will kind of do the same thing, but the person is not directly related to you. You can then go for your personality. Fighting for your acquired loyalty, which would then, if your loyalty feigns down, you will defect and you move on to another army. So, and then you can create your tier. You can move into tactics, and you can select, I think, up to three. One tactic. So you can choose your birth range if you wish to. Obviously, depending on who your parents are, you have to fit in their timeline, so you can't just go and choose anything that you so wish. And this will also affect the time at which you would appear within the game. So if the game that you're playing will not be within this period of time, your character will not feature. So you would need to pick a scenario that will be around the time of your lifespan in order for you to appear on the battlefield. Please edit how this officer will appear in each scenario. So these are the scenarios that you appear in. There are a reasonable amount of scenarios within the game, and they are pretty long. So you can just select how your character will be set within those scenarios. Go across here. We now have abilities. This is the one where you can choose up to three traits, I believe. Yeah. So if I was to do that, so I've got three traits here. And I can have my... growth type. Oh, logistics, fortitude, and then moderate, valiant. So there's quite a few things you can adjust around all these features here. So there's plenty of customization that you can make for your individual officers, which will appear within the battlefields. Back again and go into screen number 3, and here if you wanted to create a little bit of backstory for your character, you can just edit and create your own little biography. Why not put them in a historic situation, an instance from their birth, or some little backstory as to why your character is there and what they fight for, etc. So if we quit this, and leave the officer to use that this, and return. So that's a little show into the editing of your officers. And then you can also edit historical officers. And you can have samurai cat portraits, which... I do not know if you are aware of the Samurai Cats game, Nobunaga, which is a big thing in Japan, and you can change the portraits to be the Samurai Cats versions of their faces, as well as the, this is one I'm not too sure about, so I can't really comment on that, see what we can do to mess around with the historic officers. So you can change their you can change their face, you can change their personality, and you can change their tactic. You can adjust their abilities, but you can't change their bio. Their bio is as their history tells them. So that's that. And should you make a complete hash of it, hit the reset button, everything will be fine. So, let's go into a new game. Here are the various scenarios, and these are all the various warring factions within the game. So each scenario will be very, very different. You will see the flags change depending on the period of time. You can see here there are fewer flags, but there are bigger regions covered by a single army. At the beginning they're quite spread out. We have here a lot of the Nobunaga army here within this center. Not sure if we have Sanadas. Yeah, I'm going to go into the birth of Nobunaga. This is one that I kind of started, but I will start again just to show you at least a slightly aware of how this scenario goes. So within here you can create your own clan, and you can select officers to join your clan. So if I was to pick, for example, a place to start, then I could pick here. No. Okay, if we select their main base. Oh. So we have a base there. Select a crest. Various crests here. Just gonna pick one here. And that's pretty much how you've got your own little clan starting in the army, in a base here. Mess around with the history. But I'm gonna delete that. I don't need that in there. I was just showing you how you can customize your game. Edit the locations. Editing position disables historical quests, feats, and trophies. During the game, you will encounter various quests which are based on historic scenarios. And in order to progress into the next stage as such, you need to fulfill the quests within usually the set period of time. But I'm gonna come back out of here. Okay, so we are going to start as, I want to start as the Nobunaga, as the Oda clan, so. Pick them. And should you wish to make your game a lot more difficult, or mess around with the settings, make it easier, make it more balanced, there are plenty of options here to adjust your game to fit your playstyle. I'm just going to stick with an easy for the time being I'm not that great at this, but for your own game, play it however you wish. Adjust all these settings here. Again, more customization. Customization is always really, really good, especially for the longevity of the game. So it gives you more reason to keep coming back and playing it in a different way all the time. We can have battle deaths. I can have where are we? Lifespans, which means the officers will only live as long as their lifespan is. You can make them live a little bit longer, or you can make them completely ageless. But I'm going to stick with historical. I think historical is maybe the best way to play. I enjoy the history, so we can have created offices on here, quests and events, etc. You obviously want the quests and events if you want to unlock the trophies. So let's continue.
Your orders.
Right, so you will go through every month. You will have a council phase. You will then have an action phase, which is when you want to build up your city, build up your resources, try to increase your army strength, send out emissaries to recruit defecting officers. Send out emissaries to go out and make allies, which will then allow you to, which will then ease your attacks against your foes. So here's the council phase. During the council phase, we will edit our region. We have a tribe nearby. That's pretty much it. So we have a tribe and we have two armies within the region. I didn't put a scroll up on the scroll. So we have the each area within the road network, which is your means of getting between areas, and the better your road infrastructure, which you can actually improve by, just find the option, okay, that's to appease a tribe, that's to entice enemy clan officers to raise their discontent. So here's the, improve your roads. You can improve your road structure, which will then increase your income, etc. Before we continue to do anything, we will need to improve our base and resources. We will need more labour, so therefore we need to increase our population. To do so, we want to select this one. We're limited by our gold. We have our labour here. We can only do so many actions that will cost labour. Conscripts will maximise our soldiers. Crafts will maximise our income. And crops will maximise our harvest. Crops will allow us to have more conscripts. And obviously the crafts will then generate more income for us to be able to buy to upgrade our facilities, etc. So we will, and we have an overseer. Having an overseer will make these usually level up a lot quicker, and I believe it's determined by their political state. So clicking that, you'll see the red mark on the conscripts increase, decrease, which means we can have more. See the harvest go up, so that's one thing we'll do, and that'll use all our labour and spend a little bit of gold. So that's that, and we'll close out of here. In here we have three officers. So you can see, you can actually tick various tickets here. You can see flags, you can see road networks, the levels of the road, etc. province info, so you can have as much info as you want. And this is where your quests will jump in once we get one. Oda clan, they've only got 9% support from this tribe, and we want to increase that. So I'm going to send someone using diplomacy. Why not? Okay, using diplomacy, we can send someone to another faction, which will then try and create allies. Obviously, if you want to go against the ones which are friendly, more likely to become your allies. These guys have a little bit of interest. Got your normal, and then you end up with ones which are, yeah, like Scorn, and you end up with sworn enemies, etc. The ones that are going to attack you when you are a little bit weak. I don't want to do that right now. I will negotiate. Where am I? I am here. I'm going to negotiate with these guys here. And hopefully... I want to go for the one with the highest... that'll be him, but he's my overseer, and I don't want to use him because my overseer is the one that's overseeing the development of the crops. So I'm going to have to send someone else out. I will send Norimun Shida. You will go. Projected trust. And the longer you leave them in here, the trust will build up. The higher the trust, they will then become friendlier with you, and then they will so 30 months will be the planned time for completion of them becoming allies. So we're going to send them. Let's close out here. We can appease the tribe and increase their support. Now the tribe which is just up the road from us, we definitely need some support from them. They will then provide, if we were to be attacked, or we are going to attack, we can rely on their help to bring some soldiers in and aid us within battle, which is one of the best things to have when you've got tribes nearby. Just keep them up, the loyalty and the relationship, keep it positive, the better it is. Which will decrease over time, so you're going to have to keep going back and sending guys out there just to keep topping up those friendly levels. So, continue here. I've only got one officer now stuck in my base. There's an officer who will agree not to fight us. How about conspiring more and increasing their discontent? So... you'd need to increase the discontent and keep doing so until they will not fight you, or if you keep going further, they will join your army, and then you end up with more officers. I can't do it right now because I've just sent all my guys out, but you can see the people which are in the yellow and the red. The red ones are the ones you really want to go for. They're the ones which are so close to ditching the clans that they were with. So you can see the loyalty levels there. Their loyalty drops further, then they should hopefully join your clan, or at least ditch the other clan. I'm not gonna join any of that yet. And here, we can... there may be mines, secret paths, and resources to be found. These will be key for finding... for upgrading your facilities. You can upgrade your crops to and your craft areas to become markets and things like that. So, and the more... the higher that the... got a level of base features, the more income, the more crop, etc. that you're going to get, plus a few other features. So we are done from this phase. And now we can see the time passing here. I've got it set to go fast. That's a month rolling by. And then we'll go back into cancel. My liege, the key to surviving this age of war is making our town flourish and thrive. Our town lacks people and has not the wealth other lands and settlements do. First, for the sake of supporting our soldiers as well as letting us bring prosperity to our town. Okay, I kind of read that in a funny tone. So here we go, we got our first quest. Wealth and power. Okay. Country building always starts with the basics. To increase our low income, let's start by developing our town. Proceed with historic quests. Yes. Raise Oda Castle's crops to 450. And crafts to 400. And conscripts to 350. So that'll increase our army, our feed.
Let us begin the meeting.
And our income. So, it's all good stuff.
Here's last month's balance.
We'll keep tabs on this. Because the more you end up in this situation, the less of this you're going to end up with. So, you need to keep up with the... increasing your crafts, etc., to generate more income. And you will also need to occasionally dip into your funds and upgrade facilities and things, and send officers out on missions to recruit and negotiate. So that's
reporting in
expenditure. Appeasing the tribe worked well. More of them appear to be interested in us. So here we go. We've got 28%. We have here. We have zero group trust. Let's increase this. So 100 for the crops, so that's not that much. But you can only do one thing at a time. You can't do more than one, which kind of sucks, but that's the way of the game. And it'll also cost all of us all of our labour. That's that. Close there. We can have a look at the quest, we can see how we're progressing. And you get a ticket in the boxes whenever you... And should you not wish to do the quest anymore, you can just hit the quit button. So I'm going to conduct diplomacy negotiations with the Imperial Court. That will hopefully improve our court trust. So I'm going to send him back out here, increase our support by this tribe. We're going to see if we can bring it to around 80. See if we can wipe down there. Oh, hello. I have finally come of age and wish to contribute to the family however I can. Okay, so we now have a new officer. His talent contributed greatly to the clan's prosperity. Okay, the effect raises melee attack, limits enemies' movements. She seems cool. So you've made up your mind, and so have I. Come join my army.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance.
Again, we've spent out another 1,000. I believe that was for the to send out the emissary for developing relations with the tribe. I may not be able to do that next time.
Reporting in.
One of our boys has come of age. We've gained an extra retainer bonus. Appeasing the tribe went well. More of them seem to be interested in us. More bonus. Okay, so let's zoom back in again. Let's increase our crops because we could do some more money. Our income at a time is very, very low. We probably need some more castles and need some more income from a bigger land, to be honest. So let's close that. The last time I played, I was actually on a different castle. This is quite new. It's quite a different scenario. I had different quests as well. But there may be mines, secret paths, and resources to be found. So let's see how much this will cost me. It'll cost 300. And I can send... send this guy. It's less than 1,000 I was spending on the other... and we have 64% right there. And we have the diplomacy going on here. Get a notification when they want to become friends or they've sworn allies. Let's quit this month and progress further. The game tends to go a little bit slower first because you do have to develop up your castles before you can then go sending out armies to get tactical. You haven't got an army.
Let us begin the meeting.
You haven't got the resources, then. You're stuffed, pretty much.
Here's last month's balance.
If you attack unprepared, the diplomacy must be costing me 1,000. Yeah, diplomacy expense 600, and then investigation 300, and development of 100. So the diplomacy has actually cost me more money than I have income.
Reporting in.
Okay, found a fountain. Oda Castle should be a useful resource. There have been a harvest of rice, we gain extra provisions, and looks like trade has paid off. Not enough to conquer the war-torn world, though. So we're back into the stage, we will build this up even further. Okay, so that's that. Let's close there. And once certain facilities have increased, we can then, under the upgrade, but we do need the labour, as you can see, four labour to add certain facilities, five labour to upgrade base structures, two labour to restore base's HP, but we haven't lost the HP, so fine. Fortify posts, so everything will require some labour to improve. Expanding districts is one thing that we need to be doing. So I'm going to try and go through the months a little bit quicker and just spend out on upgrading facilities.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance. Reporting in.
Okay, so, additional intellect. I said intelligence, yeah. Intellect. Okay, looks like we don't have much gold. Selling rice to the merchant may be a good idea. That is one of the things I was doing before. Have the merchant.
What would you like?
Occasionally they sell some of the rare stuff, which includes weapons and their treasures, which you can then use as bribes or rewards for fellow either members of your officers to try and increase their loyalty or to establish better relations with neighboring factions. You can choose to add horses, which are a bonus for faster travel, and we can purchase, if we need it, more crop. For now, we've got 6,000 crop here, which we're not using at all, so we're going to sell.
Thank you very much.
So let's reduce our crop a little bit. Let's upgrade this. Let's upgrade our crop so we get a better harvest. And then I'll start doing the conscripts and we can build up our army a little bit. Done enough diplomacy on Uyugaya. On Uyugaya Umisugi clan to request reinforcements. Am I to continue diplomacy? No, I can send him back, which will then cost me less money. Or I can get him to continue. If I send him back, they can lose the levels of diplomacy there. They can then fall back into this neutral ground. So I'm going to leave them here for at least a month, and then we'll see where it goes from that point. So we get the notifications pop up in the bottom corner here. Okay, I have come of age and will help our family however I can. We have yet another Uda. Another child of his inheriting his talents, contributed greatly to the clan's prosperity, similar to the one. He raises ranged attack and weakens attacking enemies. Okay. Just got good leadership. Reasonably low intellect. Lowish.
Here's last month's balance.
So for those of you that know the Empires games, you'll know that each phase you would go through the cancel phase each month, and then you'll have battle phase, cancel phase, battle phase. But during the cancel phase, you'll kind of make your diplomacy and make your choices how you're going to improve and increase your army. This is kind of the same scenario.
Reporting in.
Okay, we've gained an extra retainer. Send someone out to one of these teams. Let's see if anyone's defected any further. Let's see what each of these are like. So these 12. Discontent. So let's select him and let's appoint someone to do this. I will appoint someone with some reasonably high intellect. Seems that Mr. Baby Maker is going to be the one. Projected discontent. So the planned completion will be 50 months, so it's going to be a very long process. If I return here, that one, I can change the overseer to be another officer. So if I make send. I might as well select one of these. Let's do the conscripts. Which means I can then send my better officer out to make some negotiations, and hopefully that should reduce the time. So if I do that, then it's always going to be, because I can't even change it. Oh, I can change this. So bases will, by default, work on agriculture, crafts, or conscripts. Negotiate with Mr. Matey over here. Let's appoint our key officer here. So yeah, that will now take 34 months as opposed to the 50 previously projected. So we will work on this. The cost of doing so is 30 a month, so that's pretty high. 300 a month. 30. 300 a month. My income is 344. If I'm going to do this, I may wish to stop the other guy's diplomacy. So if I come up here, go to diplomacy. Let's relieve you. Oh, planned completion 8 months later. But that's costing me 600 a month, and I don't really want to do that, so I'm going to relieve you for the time being. And let's close that. So at least I'm paying less out than I was before. Let's do the next one. the first mission accomplished.
Your orders.
You get an idea as to whereabouts in the year that you are, based on the seasons. So right now we'd be going into winter.
Here's last month's balance.
Okay, so we're actually spending out less than we were before, which is a good thing.
Reporting in.
No further reports. Again, so we have done the crops. We will do the crafts next, just to kind of increase our income. So close that. Can it increase our allies? That's cool and all, but still. So let's move forward to the next level.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance.
Oh, we got a refund of 300. Thank you. Oh, but that means my diplomacy with that other chap has stopped, but we've got a good income here and minimal expenses, which means we're going in the black right now.
Reporting in.
Pushing our way down to the red. Oh, that'll be why he's being suspected of collusion. So yeah, it's best to leave him, otherwise we may get into trouble. We don't really want that at this stage. We haven't got an army. Let's continue to increase these. Our tribe, as you can see, the tribe numbers go down, so it's a piece of tribe. And let me send. So we have a, what I didn't mention actually, we have a deadline, so we only have until July 1539 to complete these quests. If we don't complete the quests, I'm not quite too sure about the consequences. Failure conditions, here we go. I will lose Oda Castle. But upon completion, I will gain a politician trait. So, bonus. It's a simple task. The last thing I want to do is lose Oda Castle.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance.
Okay, so we're just a little bit in a lost situation there.
Reporting in.
Send him out again. Just try and increase our relations. Increase the. No, don't need to do the crops. Crafts. Crafts when you can see the market's improving here.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance.
389,400. That's not too bad. We were using a convert with regards to the tribe, so.
Reporting in.
My training has paid off and I've grown. I've still got ways to go. Yeah, so we have our fields here, which are for the crops. We have our fair here, which is for the crafts. The specialty, which is castle fair, trader, etc. Which will increase our further. We have our workshop here, which is the conscript development. Can improve our resources as well. Let's bump this up. So, sending, if I go back in here, using this feature here to serve and discover new things, you'll discover things on the fountain and other items, which will then help to increase. Building traits and relations, escape routes, and when you're in blockades, and this one here will increase the chance to do rice exchange, which is what we had a few years ago, which is a huge increase to the crop input. Now is adding baths to military districts and castles. We're going to further increase our conscripts, so we're going to get some more soldiers. I might attempt. Everyone else is too far out. But the realm is huge, there are so many factions. Oh, here we go. We have someone in the red. So I can send him out. He's sitting on 9. Our required loyalty is 10. Let's appoint. Hopefully we can persuade him to join our ranks. Send a messenger to negotiate alliances and relations. Okay, we can only do that with this one neighbouring faction. Chicago clan. But I'm not going to do it. That would kind of build them up from being normal to friendly, which then we can make allies. I've selected this, haven't I? Yeah, conscripts. So close that and skip the month. See if we've made an ally.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance.
That's because I sent the convert.
Reporting in.
Seems he's had a change of heart. Be careful if you wish to continue conspiring. I will continue conspiring. Bit of a small clan here as well, but they do have a reasonably big population compared with us. We have a population of 8,440, so it's pretty small. We have 5 officers in this small. Another tribe here. They are in our region. Ooh. The Sataki clan. They have a lot of allies, and they are probably going to be our enemies, I'm sure. Right, let's continue this.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance. Reporting in.
Match a maiden to an officer. Him to the older one. Loyalty boosts up. He seems very happy. Here we go, maybe having a new offspring.
What would you like?
So here we go, here's an example of some of the finer wares. We can have nice horses, paintings, and these will, they fetch a pretty penny, but they're a godsend for trying to make negotiations and trying to increase loyalty should you have any officers that are looking to defect. Conscripts, that's pretty much all we've got to do for the end of the month.
Let us begin the meeting. Here's last month's balance. Reporting in.
Court command, you can negotiate with court nobles. You can do three things when negotiating: diplomacy, rank, and recommend. The diplomacy command allows you to gain trust with the imperial court. When their trust reaches 100, you gain the ability to use rank, recommend, and peace commands. With the rank command, your daimyo can request a rank one higher than their current one. Controlling your palace allows you to request lower ranks as well. Gift the courts with coin befitting the rank, and it's yours. Smaller clans may be refused certain ranks. Your daimyo may will obtain the highest rank conferred. The other ranks can be given to your officers from the rank command and the retainer. After gaining the rank, you will gain a level of trust with all the other clans every month. The recommend command allows you to request other clans' daimyo to be conferred a rank. You can request a rank one stage higher than the current one. Gift the court with blah blah blah. The granting of the rank may be refused if the clan's size does not fit the rank's prestige. When your recommended daimyo gains the rank, their foreign stance towards you will turn to trusting. And this is going to cost me a lot of money, so I'm not going to do it. Not at this stage. We are definitely going to improve our conscripts, as that's the final thing we need in order to press the quest. We to see how this is going. Okay. Planned completion, 47 months. I'm still building up discontent. This is going to take a very long time. And it's going to be costing me £300. I'll see how it goes in the coming months. So, close out of that for the rest of the next month. Hopefully there should be enough conscripts. Okay, building up there.
Your orders. Here's last month's balance.
Yeah, so we're still losing money here.
Reporting in.
Having her at the top of... As I recall, I put her in charge of Overseer. And she's gaining. So she's gaining some points going here. Let's increase that. I will be going to stream this game on Friday, and hopefully I will be able to go through some battle. So this will be basically just working on the base building and the basics here, and I will hopefully move on to attacking should my plan get stronger. Hopefully it will do. Now gathering soldiers and expanding our territory has come to the realm of reality. This is the wish of the people as well. Let us bring them prosperity and love them more than ever. This is more than anything. This more than anything. Probably okay. I've gained the politician trait. Next step, unification.
My liege, our territory is still lacking. Though our people may thrive, there is a limit to how many soldiers we can support. Rather than waiting ourselves to death, let us conquer our neighbours. We must steal enemy land and increase our territory, and not just a mere fortress either. Let us aim for castles.
So it looks like we are going to go into an attacking phase, and I am going to leave it there. So here we go. Don't have many castles. You need only to steal a few. Such is the way of the world, and such is the path of the day. Proceed with historical quest, yes. So I'm going to leave it there.
Your orders.
Going to sit in this council.
Here's last month's balance. Reporting in.
And this video should go out. Should it be Friday the 28th? Friday the 28th of August. And I will be streaming, so on this very day, should that be the case. So thank you for checking out this video. Hopefully it's given you an insight as to some of the things which the game has to offer in terms of base building. I will look forward to sharing with you some of the capture and battle techniques in the next live stream. So, thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.